It's a big day. A new federal government means a new debate over an Australian republic. That's after the Albanese government quietly appointed an assistant minister for the republic, Matt Thistlethwaite.
Yeah. So, after 23 years, could there be another referendum on the future of the monarchy in Australia? Well, chair of the Australian Republic Movement, Peter Fitzsimons, joins us now. Pete, great to see you, mate. How do you read the appointment?
Well, nice to be here, Sarah and Stevie. And you say the government was quiet about it. We weren't quiet about it. It is fantastic news, a wonderful breakthrough, the greatest breakthrough for the Australian Republic Movement in 25 years. To use the felicitous phrase of that famous monarchist Lyle Shelton, he said about 6 weeks ago, and if the Albanese government is elected, there will be a minister for the crown devoted to removing the crown. And that is exactly the situation. They went into that election with that promise, and it's happened.
So are you pushing for the Queen to be removed as Australia's head of state, or are you waiting to wait until she, what's a nice way to put it, finishes her tenure?
The reality is, Stevie, I know that you and Sarah admire the Queen. Well, you've got to stand in a queue behind me. We all admire the Queen. She's been there for 70 years, I think, tomorrow or the next day. Good luck to her. I mean, that's the truth of it is. She's an extraordinary woman and we wish her well and we wish her a long life. But there is no way known that she's not in the very deep twilight of her magnificent reign. And the reality is of announcing now there's a Minister for the Republic, sorting out the referendum, bringing the people along. I mean, I wouldn't have think that there'd be a referendum within, well, 3 or 4 years, at which point we hope she's alive and we hope she's going well. But at that point, I think all of us would be very surprised if King Charles wasn't King Charles, Prince Charles wasn't King Charles.
So, Pete, Matt Thistlethwaite is the Assistant Minister for the Republican Royalists, as you mentioned there, say that the role is essentially undermining the Constitution. What will his job actually be? Is it actually... will his whole role be committed to essentially trying to remove the crown?
When you say it's undermining the Constitution's been there since 1901. It's a living, breathing thing. It's something that every now and then changes, and that's the way it is for all constitutions. So to have the will of the Australian people, and it is, over half of the Australian people want there to be a republic. 25%, I think now down to 23%, want it to be a monarchy, and the rest of them don't particularly care. And so the idea is we're going to have constitutional change. We're going to have a referendum before the people to seek to have a majority of people in the majority of states with a simple premise. Do you think that Australia can do better in the 21st century, third decade thereof, than to find our head of state from a family of English aristocrats living in a Paris palace in London? And I know, from knowing you both personally, you know, like, I'm not sure if you're monarchists or Republicans, but there'll be a lot of your viewers who go, I love the Queen, I love Prince William, all that. And the answer is, all of that will go on, Sarah and Stevie, all of it. 10 years from now, young Prince George will be spotted at Royal Ascot with young Lady Fotheringbottom. And there'll be speculation, are they going to go to the Ascot Ball together? And it'll be on the front page of the Women's Weekly, and there you'll find me at the front of the queue, because I love reading about that stuff. And it'll be on the websites, and it's all great. And all of that royal theatre, that royal pantomime, it goes on. There's no disrespect to them. Go hard. It's just that we, as a people, will be running our own show.
Now, Pete, I know how passionate you are about it. Every Australia Day barbecue at your place, I pretty much cop about 3 hours of this. But what do you think the current support is from the community for a transition to a republic? I know a slim majority want Charles or don't want Charles to become king. How do you think the public feels about it?
The support is growing. We've had a flood of donations in the last 8 days. We've had membership has gone up. And look, I've been talking about this. I've been chair for 7 or 8 years. And, you know, 7 or 8 years ago, after fantastic work by my predecessors, but the truth of it was Australia was a long time coming back from the disappointment of that last referendum, which, as you recall, was last century. But now, I mean, there's a mood of progressivism in the air right now. It's there and people want it. I'll just say one more thing, if I may. I know you both well enough to know that you both have children and that you adore. Let me say, I think you've both got, from memory, I think you've got daughters. Well, I know you've got daughters.
Daughters
let's
and
just
boys,
say
yeah.
OK, but let's just say that with your daughters right now. At this point, your 10-year-old daughter can aspire to be anything she wants in this world. She can aspire to cure cancer at the age of 20, peace in the Middle East by the age of 25, and win an Oscar by the age of 30. There's one thing your children right now cannot aspire to be. As young Australians, they cannot aspire to be the Australian head of state. Why? Because in the colonial constitution we were given from Great Britain, it says you pissant little Australians need not apply to be the head of state of your own country because you're Australians and that job is reserved for a family of English aristocrats. I mean, seriously, both of you, you must... I ask you, do you recognise the absurdity and the sheer indignity of that for a proud people of a proud nation? May I ask?
I think it probably needs to happen, but... Oh, it's a big debate to have right at this moment. It's costly. It's about $250 million to get this up and running.
It's not expensive. This is not an exercise of calling in Joe's bulldozers and doing $500,000 of reconstruction. This is an exercise simply of political will, of mustering the same wherewithal that Barbados has mustered last year to say, we're doing this on our own. There are 54 nominations in the Commonwealth. 38 of them haven't gone, this is too expensive, this is too hard. 38 of them have said, we're mature enough to do this on our own. And what we at the Australian Republic Movement, we want Sarah Harris and we want Steve Jacobs to look down the barrel of the camera and say, hey, we're voting for our daughters. We're voting for our children. We believe that our children, our young Australian children, are every bit as good and more Australian than young English people. I mean, seriously, it can't be that hard. Come on.
Let's put it to a referendum then, Pete.
Yeah, I love your passion, Lord Fotheringbottom. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. And could you give that Lisa a big cuddle for me, please?
You barely let me get a word in edgeways.